Hi there. I'm Matt with K15T, and we are going to talk about how you can restrict a piece of content in a Confluence space so only a few people can see it or edit it, and also how to control who can do things in a space at all. So let's jump right into something you might be dealing with right now. Let's say you're part of an HR team working for an organization that is about to start employing people globally. Very exciting, but there's a lot of work to do. One of the things you need to do is update your employee handbook space that currently everybody is a viewer of. You need to be able to add new pages or work on existing pages in a way where only a restricted group of people can see the page or be able to edit it. And to do that, you would go to the share menu. Here in the share menu, I can toggle from the page being open to the page being restricted. That is, I'm going to say only some of my teammates should be able to see it. Here, I can add teammates I want to be able to access it, and I can set whether they should be able to edit or just view it. I'll hit share here, and now I can see at the top of the page, there is a red padlock icon. This red padlock icon means the page is now restricted and is only accessible to some people. I can go back in the share menu and see who it's accessible to, and I can even change those permissions. So for example, I'm realizing Conrad should actually just be a viewer of the page. So I'm going to hit save, and now that will update who can see what. Now, one important thing to know is for those people who are not allowed in this page, so they're not in that restricted group, they will not see the page show up in the content tree, and it will not show up in search results as well. So it is, in fact, restricted. Now, while you might be tempted to restrict a whole bunch of things in Confluence, that is not the way restrictions are intended to be used. You should only restrict content when only a few eyes should be on it. Only a few people should have access to it. So think I should restrict updating HR policies and salary review pages. You don't want to restrict things like page drafts. If you're drafting a page or a live doc and you don't want people to modify it, you should instead think about using content statuses on the page where you can set a status of rough draft to communicate, hey, I'm still drafting this, please stay out. Or you could use a status element or a panel element at the top of the page to indicate, hey, this is still in progress. Please don't chime in. Please don't make changes. Now, you might also run into situations where you share the link to a restricted page with someone else who doesn't have the ability to access it. It looks something like this. They can request access from you, but you might be like, why can't they access this page? This is strange to me. So you can go back into the share menu, and first of all, you can see where the access request is and you can grant access, but you can also, if you are using Confluence Premium or Enterprise, hit the More menu and select Inspect Permissions. Here, you can enter the name of the person you shared the page with, and it will give you a full breakdown of what they do and do not have access to. So here you can see they have access to Confluence and they have access to view things in the space, but the page itself is not accessible to them. And if we expand, we can actually learn that they don't have access to this page because the parent page is actually restricted. And in Confluence, when a parent page is restricted, all of the child pages are also restricted to those same people. So now we understand exactly why this person can't access the page. Now let's say the HR team wants to partner with the legal team because while the HR team is writing all the new policies, the legal team needs to review them to make sure they meet the standards for the areas y'all will be operating. So this is where a space administrator comes in. So the space admin has the admin role, which means they can do all the things, including changing settings in the space. There are some people who can be managers, so they can modify settings for people and modify content, but they can't change space settings. We are going to add the legal team as collaborators. That means they can edit and add content in the space, whereas everybody else in the company, they're viewers in the space. So that means they can view the content in the HR space and they can comment on it, which is just perfect. Now you might be thinking, okay, those roles that I can assign to people are good, but what if I need something very specific? Like people with this role can do this, this, and this, but not this, this, and this. Well, hold on, because there's one more level of permissions we need to talk about. The final layer of permissions and restrictions in Confluence are what are called global permissions. And really all you need to remember is those are your Confluence administrators. They can tweak all the buttons and knobs in the whole of Confluence, and they are helpful to you for two reasons. First, if you have a page or pages that are restricted that no one seems to be able to get access to or can figure out why other people can't get access, Confluence administrators have the ability to remove the restrictions of a piece of content if necessary. Notifications will be sent out that this has happened, but this is really helpful if something just seems inaccessible and nobody else can figure out how to get to it. Finally, your Confluence administrator can create a custom role you can use when bringing people into your spaces. So maybe you want to make a custom role for the legal team where they can add and delete content, but they can't export any content from the space, for example. Your administrator has all sorts of toggles where they can set very specific and minute permissions for each role. So you can work with your Confluence administrator to create the custom roles you need to keep all your content accessible to just those people who should be able to use it. And that is restrictions and permissions in Confluence, the tools your team needs to make sure the right eyes are on your content. At K15T, we very rarely use restrictions or permissions to keep people out of things because we find in general things work best when people have access to all the information that every team is working on. Although sometimes we do need to restrict a page or two or have a space or two where not everybody has permissions. But for the most part, openness is key. Speaking of openness, we have created all sorts of other videos on our channel exploring all things Confluence, so check those out. Also, sign up for our amazing weekly Confluence newsletter, link in the description below. Please follow along with us as we continue to explore how to use Confluence to share what you do best.